The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two, and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for their journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. But they were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. A blessed Sunday to all of you. Could you kindly bless the person beside you by greeting a blessed Sunday. Yan. Allow me to start our reflection for today with a story. Don't worry, I'll make this very, very quick just before you sleep. Please listen to this story. One day, a man named Truth and a man named Lie stood by a river just outside the town. What are the names of the men? Ayun, just testing kung gising pa po. No? Truth and Lie. Actually, they are twin brothers. Lie challenged Truth to a race, claiming that he could swim across the river faster than Truth. Lie laid out the rules to the challenge, stating that they both must remove all their clothes, and at the count of three, they should dive in to the freezing cold water and swim to the other side and back. Yun yung rules. Malinaw. Huhubarin ng damit, pagbilang ng tatlo, tatalon, lalangoy, at babalik. Lie counted to three. But when Truth jumped in, Lie did not. Who jumped? Who did not? Yan. Tinitest ko lang po kung nakukuha pa at nakakasunod. And so, as Truth swam across the river, Lie put on Truth's clothes and walked back into town dressed as Truth. He proudly paraded around the town, pretending to be Truth. Truth made it back to the shore. But his clothes were gone, and he was left naked with only which clothes? Lie's clothes to wear. Refusing to dress himself as Lie, Truth walked back to the town naked. People stared and glared at him, looked at naked Truth walking through the town. He tried to explain what had happened and that he was, in fact, Truth. But because he was naked and uncomfortable to look at, people mocked at him and shunned him, refusing to believe he was really truth. Sino sa tingin niyo po ang mas pinaniniwalaan? Hello. Ayun, tulog na. The people in town chose to believe lie because he was dressed appropriately, covered, and easily to look at. From that day until this, people have come to believe a lie rather than believe a naked truth. From then until this day, people have come to believe a lie rather than believe a naked truth. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the lesson that we could learn from our readings today. In our first reading, God sent Amos to be a prophet in Israel. And he told the Israelites the message of God. Pinadala si Amos para maging propeta at ipangaral ang salita ng Diyos. Ituro kung ano ang tama at mabuti. But instead of listening to Prophet Amos, Amaziah told Amos to bring his prophesying back to his own country. They don't want to listen to him in Bethel. Dalin mo yung mga pinagsasabi mo dun sa bansa mo. Huwag dito. Huwag mo kaming turuan. Hindi kami makikinig sa'yo. Grabe, no? Tinuturuan mo na ng tama, hindi na nga pinakinggan, tinaboy ka pa. Sinasabi mo lang naman kung ano ang mabuti, sa halip na tanggapin, hinamak at ginawa ka pang masama. Anong klaseng bansa yung ganun? Anong klaseng bansa yung pinaparating mo lang naman ang turo ng Panginoon pero minamasama ng tao? Pinapangaral mo lang naman ang katotohanan, sa huli, ikaw pa ang kontrabida. Anong bansa iyon? May kilala ba kayong ganong bansa? Oh, wag na kayo sumagot. Hindi ako nagtatanong, no? Sa isip na lang, no? Tinuturuan mo, ikaw pa masama. Sinasabi mo lang naman ang mensahe ng Diyos. Tinataboy. Kaya lagi, no? Kawawa ang mga nangangaral ng katotohanan. Dahil sa huli, sila pa ang ipinagtatabuyan. Mahirap magsabi ng katotohanan. Kaya nga ang iba, pinipili na lang ang kasinungalingan. Pero kahit anong takip mo na gawin sa kasinungalingan, kailanman hindi iyan magiging katotohanan. Kahit anong takip mo sa kasinungalingan, kailanman hindi yan magiging katotohanan. Kahit sabihin mong sa farm ka lumaki, sa huli lalabas. Kahit anong pakita mo ng birth certificate, sa huli lalabas ang katotohanan. Kahit nag-homeschooling ka pa, sa huli hindi yan ang katotohanan. Pero makakalungkot, we believe in lies. Pinaniniwalaan natin ang kasinungalingan. Bakit? Kasi tinakpan, binihisan para maging katotohanan. Pero yan pa rin ay kasinungalingan. This is the reason why Jesus reminded his apostles in our gospel that if a place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them. The apostles were sent on a mission, and their mission is to proclaim the kingdom of God, to tell the good news, to tell the truth. But part of it, Jesus is warning them that not everybody will accept them. Not everybody will believe them. And not everybody will welcome them. So if that happens, they should shake the dust of their feet and leave. Kung hindi sila tatanggapin at paniniwalaan, hindi nila kailangan makipagtalo. Hindi nila kailangan makipag-away. Ipagpag nila ang alikabok sa kanilang mga paa upang hindi nila mabitbit ang mga hindi pagtanggap sa kanila ng bayang iyon. Yun ang ibig sabihin, shake off the dust para hindi mo mabitbit yung hindi nila pagtanggap sa iyo. You know, my dear people, not all people easily accept the truth. Kaya nga, sabi nila, truth hurts. Some would rather create their own truth to cover up the lies, thinking that they could deny the truth. But in the end, they just turn themselves into liars. They just turn themselves into liars. You cannot conceal the truth. So don't lie. Be truthful. Accept the truth. This is what Jesus is teaching us and telling us. Hindi ba ang kasinungalingan pinagtatakpan natin? Iniisip natin, yun ang katotohanan. You don't need to do that. Accept the truth. God can forgive the lies that you have covered up. My dear brothers and sisters, truth is not about what you believe is true. Minsan ganun tayo eh, no? Ito yung katotohanan sa akin. Ito yung totoo. About divorce, ito yung totoo sa akin. But it's not about what you believe is true. Truth is about what God says. That is the truth. Kahit masakit, kahit mahirap, kahit ang hirap tanggapin, that's the truth. What God says. Truth is not about what you believe is true. It is about what God says, which always and forever, the truth. Amen.